Hi, this is Dr. A. Let's continue our introduction to medical terminology. We're going to continue with some of the rules for building words. So as a reminder, words can have a prefix, but not all medical terms have prefixes. Prefixes indicate the location of an organ, number of parts, time of frequency. Then it will have a word root, which is the foundation of the word, gives it its general meaning, and often refers to a body system or body part. Then you have a combining vowel, which can be O or I, and you will find it between root words or between the root word and its suffix, and it makes the word easier to say. And then your suffixes are the ending, and it can indicate a condition, a disease, etc., many other things. The combining forms are always the word root plus the combining vowel. So let's say if you have a term to be translated, you have a medical term in front of you, like gastroenterology. You want to divide a term into its word parts. One of the clue is often the presence of wherever the O's are. Since the O's are combining vowels, you can kind of see where the word might break up. So in this one, you have gast, O, enter, O, and then logy. All right, and so then you want to define each word part. So gast means stomach, O is the combining vowel. Enter means small intestine, and then O is the combining vowel, and logy means the study of. So altogether, this means the study of the stomach and small intestine. So a little bit on pronunciation. So it will differ according to your place of birth and education, to a region of the world. Even in the U.S., you will see people in the South will pronounce words slightly differently than people on the East Coast or the West Coast or further up north. The people in the UK may spell it differently, not spell it, may say it differently than the people in the US or the people in Canada. So when in doubt, if you're not sure, you can ask for the spelling or ask for confirmation. In our textbook, new terms are always going to be introduced in bold type, followed by a phonetic spelling in parentheses, and the stressed syllables are always in capital letters. So for example, in this one, pericarditis, that means the die here is capitalized. It means that's where the emphasis is when you pronounce the word. There is only one correct way to spell a term, even if there are several ways people might pronounce it, depending on their location, geographical location, or background. You don't get to make up spelling of the medical term. So changing one letter in a word can change the meaning of a word. For example, abduction, which means moving away, is different than adduction, which means moving towards. And it's just one letter difference, right? Ilium, which is small intestine, is not the same as ilium, which is hip bone. And the only difference here is the difference between an I and an E, right? So spelling is really important in your medical terminology. Next is singular and plural endings. So many medical terms come from the Greek or Latin. And so the rules for foreign plurals in these languages are different than from English. For example, the plural of atrium is atria, not atriums. But other words will follow the English rules, so ventricles, the plural is ventricles with an S. And so it's good to learn those that are Greek or Latin, to learn the singular and plural together when you study. All right, so that's some general rules here for the plurals, and then we'll wrap it up. So the words that end in A, especially if they're like Greek or Latin, like vertebrae, the plural is going to be vertebrae. You add a little E at the end. A word that ends in ax, like thorax, will be thoraces, C-E-S. If they end in X or ix, like appendix, it'll be appendices. If they end in is, like metastasis, the plural is metastases, with an E-S. If they end in ma, like sarcoma, it's going to be sarcomata. If they end in an nx, like phalanx, it's going to be phalanges, so ges at the end. If they end in on, like ganglion, is ganglia. And us, like nucleus, is going to be nuclei. in like ovum or atrium in our example, it's going to be ova or atria. And if they end in Y, biopsy, the plural is biopsies, I-E-S. So those are some rules to remember so that you can spell your terms correctly. All right, so that wraps up our quick little ones on some more rules for building your medical terms.